Yeah, herzlich willkommen.
Welcome to the 8th part of the project Transall. And if you already subscribed my channel or follow me on Facebook and Instagram, you have seen my onboard crash video of the laser that just broke in half. So maybe now it's a good idea to do that if you haven't. But now let's talk about the project Transall and the answer to the question that was in the last part. What's the actual weight? And it's exactly 7 kilograms, so 15.5 pounds, but still without the horizontal stabilizer. And that is what this part is all about. So I think let's get to work. So when I put all pieces of the Transall together in the last part, I did some measurements and ran around the airplane and measured like the distances from the wingtips to the nose and the tail. And I found out that the vertical stabilizer is not exactly vertical. So there's something warped here in the back where the last spars are. And now I have to cut all the stringers loose from the last spar 35 that's in the very end, and then turn the spar a little bit clockwise so that it's getting upright, fix the stringers again, and then I also have to change a little bit the angle of the spars up here. It's very annoying, but I have to make sure the vertical stabilizer is really vertical, so let's get to work. We'll be right back. So I got the guide tube in place and fixed it provisionally with some super glue, but all the parts are bending too much. And I cannot measure the exact measurements and angles because of that. So I will now proceed with the leading edges for the wings and the horizontal stabilizers and get them in place to stiffen everything. And then I can measure the distances and check if all angles are correct. And if it's all fine, I will glue in the guide tube with epoxy finally. And then to prevent the horizontal stabilizer to turn around that tube, I have to install a second tube and maybe a third tube to just prevent that turning and to get it really fixed to the fuselage. This was a work I was trying to avoid for so long, but finally I had to do it. That's cutting and sanding all the leading edges. I didn't find a suitable piece of wood, so I just glued those parts together here to have it high enough for the leading edge, because the leading edge here has 15 millimeters thickness, but the height is decreasing from 36 millimeters here to 21 millimeters at the end. And I think I got it quite symmetrically already. A little bit work is to be done. And as I only found stringers that were 1 meter long, I have to do it out of two pieces to get the 1.35 meters that is needed for the outer wings. But that is only the left wing. Also have to do the right wing, the horizontal stabilizers and the vertical stabilizer. So I think I will produce some more kilograms of balsa wood dust and sit here some more hours.